Started with one kid, and now currently we got 323 kids. This presentation highlights the mission, achievements, current needs, and ways to give to support the organization. When I came here for the first time, I did not know what to start with because I started from scratch, so I did not have achievement. I only had the challenges, but I thank God today I am talking about the achievements that we have made through your support. And our mission is to provide a safe, nurturing environment for over 323 children, ensuring their basic needs, education, and overall well-being. Our mission, provide balanced diet, clothing, health care, education, and accommodation to vulnerable children in our mission center, and create a supportive and loving community for every child. That is our mission. And the photo here just shows what is in our new property and is what in our old property. So you could see there in our new property, that is developed Father Constantinos. You could see there is that development, there is church over there, and there is water, the borehole I'm talking about there, and this one is water tower. And on top of the water tower, there are reservoirs, and the small house here is the powerhouse. And you could see down here, we are trying to supply the water. In our old facility where we are still, and you could see our kids there. Outdoor activities are ongoing, and the classrooms and some of the dormitories, and you could see Father Constantinos there serving tea to our children and also some bread. And you could see over there the reservoirs I was talking about, together with the water tower. So I will talk about the achievements that we have made so far in a period of 5 to 6 years. And the first thing, because I have put them in order, we were able to buy the land, acquired enough land to build the school facility, because land is everything. There's nothing you could do minus land. The second thing was building the church, which we consecrated recently. And also, we have done the dormitories, the first phase. The first photo over there, you could see, elaborates more about the land. You could see this piece of land here. Yeah. And this one, where we have built the church, and the other piece here. There are 6 acres of land. And now what we are doing with this land is to build permanent structures. And you could see the church is there, as well as the dormitories back there, which I will elaborate in the next picture or the next photo. after land, we were now to drill the borehole. So this one is another achievement. After we bought the 6 acres of land, we drilled the borehole. Remember, this achievement happened when I came in the United States through one of the parishioners here. So we bought the land, and now we were able to sink the borehole in our own property. The other property is leased property. So you could see I am there, provide access to clean water for the school, church, and the surrounding community. You would wonder why we have all this. We are trying to supply now the water, which is here, to the community. And this happened because we got a booster of solar panels. So we were able now to have enough power to pump the water to a longer distance, at least to reach out to the neighborhood And also the solar power is helping us also to generate power for our facilities like church, as well as the dormitories. And that photo tells it all. You could see here, these are new solar panels that help us now to do whatever I have said. And you could see here, we have got enough water, and we have an elevated water tower. So this water is able now to reach to the entire community. We did this recently when we got these new solar panels. That's why you could see me over there trying to fix the pipes so that we could supply the water to the neighborhood. So that is one of the great achievements that came from this church. So receive our gratitude, because water is life, as they put it. If we did not have water, we would not be in a position to run this project. We were also able to have the pipes there. You could see now I have moved from the school property, because we are reaching out now to the neighborhood. So those are the roads that connect to the neighborhood. Still elevated water tower, installed a tower with 20,000 liter water tanks and piping to ease access to clean water. Community impact: these developments have significantly improved living condition and health for the orphanage and the neighboring community. From that achievement now, remember we started with the land, water, and now spiritual achievement. In our own land, we were able now to construct, to build this church. When I was building this church, because I had visited here already, this blue car, I got it from this church. I was like, what will be reminding me this blessing? And I thought, let's have a blue colored sheets. So whenever I see this church, I remember you, and it is in blue and white, so that I could remember you always. Similarly, inside, you could see faithful there receiving Holy Communion, and it also has blue and white colors. I got it from this church. And recently, in January 26th this year, we had consecration of this new cathedral. Two bishops were there. That is Bishop Macarius here. He is from Cyprus, but he serves in Kenya. And Bishop Neophytos. He was ordained or consecrated in the year 2015. So they had come. This one had come all the way, at the long distance, because this is my bishop. So he invited this one, and he had to come. This, when I was in seminary school, the Archbishop Macarius was the dean in our seminary, and this one was not yet a bishop. He was a priest and was the deputy dean. So this one was my spiritual father then. So he had to come and witness this blessing of a church. And here with me is Anne, the Polish lady, who came for consecration. She also contributed much when we were constructing the church. And she had called me in Poland to go and solicit some fund for this development. So she is holding St. Irene's icon. She came with it all the way from Poland as a gift. And now we have it in our pulpit. Whenever we get in the church, we kiss that icon. Here was during the procession. We were going around three times during consecration. And we were reading, and other people would follow. And you would see the church was full of very to its capacity, actually. And some other people were even outside. We had to put screen like this one outside, so that those people who were outside would see what was going on in our in inside. And you could see Archbishop Bakari because he's the bishop in charge there. That one is the first photo, the first thing to do when we are consecrating the church. Kneeling down and having a prayer. When you get in the Orthodox church and you see this sign, it tells you that that church is consecrated in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. That sign just simply means Jesus Christ. So whenever you get that sign, you know that that one is a consecrated church. And when the Bishop Macarius visit our church, children are ever happy. And if we had a running, it would be interrupted because they want to see Muzungu. We call Muzungu the white people. Muzungu. When you come, it's Muzungu. So they would want to come, play with his beards, and listen to his soft words. So that one is outside our church. And this photo is during the consecration, is what it starts during consecration. And you could see the bishop was here from Erodoret. And we would have, there is always a small hole here. And we would have names of those people who are in the church and those who helped to build the church, the benefactors. And we had your names here actually. And we put it there. And the other achievement is dormitory. Now, here also you come in, and this one are our facilities, our old facilities. That is what is elaborated here. You could see our old classrooms, our old dormitories, and children, and whatever happens in our mission center. And when I came here for the first time, this is the photo that I showed you. It was our current dormitory, and you had compassion with us, and we were able to start building the dormitories now in our new property. So if you would look here, it's a story building. You have the first floor here, the second one, and the kids, we are very much happy to come and witness the progress. And this one now is inside the dormitory. You could see they are happy, and it looks now conducive. Those are our boys, and those are our girls. One dormitory that you have helped us build has a capacity of 20 children. And this is how it looks outside. Now you could see it from outside. These are 6 dormitories that we have built. Now from the previous one, you have seen the old one, and now this is the new one. And we have 6 dormitories. However, we need 6 more for us to be in a position to accommodate 240. Orphans who live there, because now we are able to shelter 120 kids. The rest are in our old facility, and the rest go to our foster homes. And our urgent needs come in, build more dormitories, equipping the dormitories with beds, headings, wardrobes, and more. Building enough toilets and bedrooms, and build better classrooms for all the children in the orphanage. So when we are done with the dormitories, we shall start building the classroom, because we want to move from the old to the new. And this is our future plan. This is what we want to have in our St. Irene's Orthodox Mission Center. That's why, if you could look at our first photo here, you can see the first floor, and now we are on the second floor. And that is what is shown in this in this building here. So we are trying to start here with this floor, and then we are somewhere here. And then from there, the first floor will take the classrooms, the second one will be dormitories. And this one will be a pollution block, or where we shall have offices and the other rooms for that would help, like offices. And you could see the parking and a good area. I am sure you got this here in America. And how you can support us. Your contribution can make a significant difference. Here is how you can help. We got a website, which is very active and explains everything, what we do. So when you go, you click this link, you will see how you would help. You would decide either to help or support a project, or you would decide to sponsor a child. And not only a project, because we are done with the church, we are done with water, and we are done with land. So what we want to do is to shelter all the kids. So you would support donating for the dormitory facility. Also, you would sponsor a child. It is unfortunate when there was crisis between the Greek and the Russian church. Some of my sponsors left because they felt like we are not connected anymore. So some of the kids here who are sponsored by the Russian church, now as we speak, they don't have the sponsors because they withdrew when there was crisis between the Ukrainian church, Russian, and the Greek church. So I am still looking for people to chip in and fill the gaps. And then not only that, you would volunteer your time and skill. If you would come in Kenya, you teach the children over there, you engage in building this facility, it would also, we shall embrace that. And spread the word about our mission and needs. So when you are seated here, you would light on social media about us, about our plight, about our needs. And that will help other people to know about us and support us. God bless you and live many years. Those are the miles that we have gone so far. And we hope and believe by the grace of God, we shall do more things that please God. Thank you for your time and generosity. Your support means the world to us and the children we care for. Thank you. Thank you.